Helping you become the best Hangout guest or the best Hangout on Air guest is the goal of this video. Hi, my name is Ronnie Bincer. I'm known as the Hangout Helper. Hangouts and Hangouts on Air are live video chats between you and up to 9 other people. And when you're invited into a Hangout call, you're going to want to be as comfortable as possible. So I've made this video to help you know what to expect, to give you a few tips along the way, and to make it so that, if possible, the technology will just disappear and you'll be inside the video room communicating your message as efficiently as possible. This video is going to be divided into multiple sections, and these items on the side here are going to be clickable. So we'll start out with the invite, meaning how do you get into the video call to begin with. So we'll look into the different ways you can get into the call. Then we go to the environment, and that means your lighting, your backdrop, the equipment that you might use to do your Hangout. The next section is going to be talking about the actual Hangout tools or the interface itself, meaning where are the tools, where are the buttons you want to click. And last but not least, we'll talk about some special tips that will help you make the best impression possible using Hangouts. So when you're invited into a Hangout, you're going to hear kind of like a ringing sound, like a telephone ringing, and you can answer that any way you can possible. One of the ways is to choose this little bell thing in the upper right, which is called the notifications. And I'm going to show a screenshot of what that looks like right here. All right, so if I was someone else, I'm inviting Peg to this call. All she's got to do is click where the bell is. It'll drop down. You'll see this big picture of the person or page inviting you, and you just click the Join Hangout button. Now, that's when you've been doing this for a little while. When you're brand new, it's not that easy to find sometimes. So I'm going to move to the next thing. This is my biggest tip for finding your way into a Hangout. Go to the page or to the profile that's actually inviting you into the call, and then look for this area that says that somebody's invited you into the Hangout. You'll see join a video call with in the name of the person or people. And then you can click where it says Join Hangout. That will bring you right into the video call. But when you get on the way, you're going to see something like this. You might see this window. Basically, it shows you the profile or the pictures of the people that are currently in the call that you're going to be joining. And you can click the Join button. Or you might see something that looks like this. This is allowing you to join a Hangout on Air, which is the live broadcast version of a Hangout call. What's different here is you have to go through the legal disclaimer, basically saying you understand you're going to be recorded and broadcast live. So you would check the box and click the Join button, and that is what brings you into the Hangout video call. So now that we're on the inside of the Hangout interface, let's talk about your environment. First thing we're going to talk about is the most important thing, and it's going to be a surprise for many of you, but it's the sound. The sound is what's most important, the audio quality. So what I do is I recommend that people get a headset, kind of like what I've got on. It separates the microphone from the speaker, eliminating the possibility for echo. If you're using a laptop, there's a good chance you're going to get some echo because the speaker is right next to the microphone, and that causes problems. So if a headset just doesn't look good for you, then go ahead and get some earbuds, maybe stick those in, something to make it so that the speaker's sound does not get right into the microphone. Next thing that I'm going to talk about is your camera. Most people's built-in webcams are plenty fine. If you need to, go ahead and get another one, a separate one that you can mount in a different spot so that you're able to look at it more efficiently. Doesn't really matter that much. Most of the webcams are HD quality, and that's pretty much what you want to have. Next, we talk about the lighting. If you want good light in front of you, you're going to want it to be brighter in front of you than it is behind you. That's the biggest key, really, bottom line. Get more light shining on your face than is shining from behind you. And the last thing to be concerned about, really, is your backdrop, meaning something like this. Now, I've gotten a little fancy, but you don't have to get that fancy. You just basically need to have a relatively clear background so that it just doesn't look messy. Now, one way that you can verify that it doesn't look messy is when you're inside of a Hangout like this one, you go to the bottom right corner where you see the icon that says you and click on it, and that will let you see what it looks like to everybody else. And that's the best way to see whether the mess is visible or not. I've got a mess around me, but you'd never know because I've cleared it away enough so that the Hangout works. Now we'll talk about the actual Hangout interface or the tools that are on the inside of the interface, the buttons that you push. And when you're inside the interface and you don't see any tools, here's the biggest number one tip I can give you. Wiggle your mouse. Move it around. So when you move your mouse around, you will see the tools show up. You'll see them on the top here, which is what we're going to talk about first. Then we'll talk about stuff that's on the bottom. And then later we'll talk about the stuff that's on the side. So here we go. Right above my head, this first icon you see here is allowing you to invite people, depending on the kind of Hangout that you're in. If you click on it, it'll bring you up to this dialog box where you can invite some folks, but we're going to cancel and move on. This next one is for muting your microphone. Okay, click on it and it mutes you so nobody can hear you. Click on it again and it unmutes you. This next one's for your camera. You can turn your camera on or off. Then we've got this thing for bandwidth settings, meaning how fast is your internet. You can adjust the speed of what the Hangout is expecting. And then last but not least, actually not very last, but the next tool is this gear. Let's click on it for a second. This is going to bring you into the place where you can make adjustments that will stay put. And the next time you come in, it'll be set that way. So if you're having a hard time with your sound, your camera, or your speakers, your mic, all that stuff can be adjusted right here. Then you click save, and whatever you choose will be saved for the next time you come into your Hangout. So that's an important place to go. The last thing you don't want to do right away is click on this little hang up button. That's your exit button. That'll actually leave the Hangout and you'll go away. Now, when you arrive first to your Hangout, you might end up being muted. In other words, this microphone might be red. And I'm going to bring up a screenshot to show what that's going to look like. So if it does happen to be red, you've got the ability to click it again on the very top so that people can hear you, or on your own profile on the bottom right corner. And that's going to allow you to unmute yourself so that you're going to be able to be heard. Here, though, once you've gotten into the habit of muting and unmuting, it's a good idea to do self-muting. In other words, if you're in a conversation, just like this particular screenshot shows, David was talking, I had him blue boxed, and I was the person interacting with him. These two gentlemen had muted themselves, as shown by these little yellow arrows. There's little white icons that show a muted microphone. That's something that you're going to want to do. It's just a good idea, good etiquette for being in a Hangout. This stuff, the film strip on the bottom, is the portion that we're going to go to next. So we started up on the top with the tools on the top. Now let's talk about the stuff that's on the bottom. When you're in a Hangout and you blue box yourself, I'll go back to this one again, that means, or you blue box somebody, that's going to change what you see in the main window. If you blue box yourself, then you're going to see yourself. And that's something, again, I mentioned that you want to do just to verify that everything looks the way you're expecting it to look. When you're done checking out what you look like, go ahead and click on that blue box again and it will turn it off. And basically, the Hangout will switch back and forth based on who's speaking, meaning the sound causes a switching of the camera. Then, when you do have yourself blue boxed, there's some special options that we've got with this interface for the Hangout. So if you click on yourself, you can see that you've got some settings here. These are called filters. The default filter nowadays is enhanced. I encourage you to either change it to smooth or some of the other ones, or I specifically like to use the one called original, which means it's not doing any special filtering. You might find it to be handy. Just depends on what you're trying to get your look to look like. Here is what enhanced looked like, at least for me, because my lighting is pretty good. It actually doesn't look so good, so I change it to original. Now, we talked about the stuff on the top. We talked about the thumbnails that were down on the bottom. Now let's look over on the side. Again, wiggling your mouse to make sure all these things show up. These are what are called Hangout apps. Okay? Hangout apps are sort of ways to customize your experience inside the Hangout experience. The ones shown here are the defaults. And if you don't see the ones that you want, you can go ahead and click on the very bottom part where there's three more dots, and that'll fly out and let you find some more. Now, we're back here live, and I'm going to basically show you the most commonly used apps that are on the left. This top one's called Chat. When you click on it, you'll see over here a little window open up. This is where you want to look in case somebody's actually trying to get your attention while you're in the Hangout, except they're not talking to you, they're actually typing to you. This is a place for everybody that's on the inside, or what's called that film strip area, to communicate via text. That's called group chat. And you turn these things on and off the same way by clicking on them on the left side. That's the easiest way to do it. The next one is really, really popular when you're doing presentations. It's for screen sharing. Then this allows you to take screenshots. And by the way, I don't really suggest using this. And then there's other tools, right? I said the three dots, it'll pop up and you'll see some other choices. This is a very popular one here as well called the Hangout Toolbox, which we'll get to in a little bit. So this last section, we're going to be talking about appearance or some extra tips to make sure you do the best you can inside your Hangouts. So first thing we're going to be doing is we're going to be looking at the camera, just like I've been trying to do during this whole filming here. The default action, or meaning what most people want to do, is they want to look down at that film strip because that's where the people are and they're moving. But when you do that and you're talking to them, it really looks like you're not talking to the right people. So you're going to want to try to establish something to train yourself. Sometimes you put a little arrow or something nice and obvious right there to grab your attention right by the camera and make sure that you're looking at the camera, because that's really going to make it look like you're looking at the people when you're talking to the camera. I know it sounds a little odd, it takes a little getting used to, so this is another tip. Get into a Hangout and start practicing on your own, and then bring some of your friends in and get them to help you practice, and then you'll feel more comfortable in the environment. Okay. Another thing you're going to want to do is turn on what's called the lower third, and that's part of the Hangout Toolbox, and that's over on this side here where you choose and can find the Hangout Toolbox. And if you don't have that there, go ahead where it says Add Apps and you can grab it. I'm going to simply turn it on and that's going to load it up. And then on this side where the first icon is, we can click on it. It'll bring up some branding basically. Now you've got some standard stuff that you can turn on. If I do that, then basically it just turns on my name. This is the more common thing that you're going to see from most people. Okay, then you can get a little bit fancier. If you happen to have some graphic skills, you can go ahead and add in some lower thirds and do some branding. Now, if it looks backwards to you, which is common, click on this little icon here where I'm pointing in the upper right side. That's going to allow you to basically flip your video around so that it's not backwards. All right, so again, I can have this set, leave it the way I want it, and then basically I go back and click on the icon on the left. And then we go to more of a full screen environment. And the last tip, very, very important, is to smile. Because smiling makes you seem more approachable. And more approachable means that people are going to receive your message a lot easier. So if by now you've decided that you need to keep up with Hangouts, or you definitely want to because they're going to be part of your future, you can follow me at Google+, or you can check out my website, which is thehangouthelper.com. Or for the deep dive and you really want to keep up, you should sign up to keep up with the Hangout Mastery membership site. See you there.